Well, good morning, everyone. It's Mr. Baird here, the pastoral care chaplain. You know what? I hope you're having a fantastic day so far, and I can't wait to see what we're going to be learning in this morning's devotion. You know, recently I've been doing something very interesting. I've actually moved home. Now, I'm wondering, have you ever moved house before? Can you remember what it's like? Usually it involves a lot of these things. Boxes. It involves a lot of heavy lifting and a lot of hard work. But anyway, I've just moved home and I'm really enjoying my new space. Now, one of the things I was really excited about when I moved was figuring out where I was going to put my bookcases and all of my books. I'm a little bit of a book nerd and a bookworm. So I've been really looking forward to figuring out what position, what genre of book I'm going to place. So that's something I've been looking forward to. Now, just yesterday, when I got home, my wife did something really thoughtful. Mrs. Baird did something really thoughtful. She saw all of these boxes. Now, currently, just down here, I've got a ton of boxes. They're all there. They're all still heavy. Maybe even this one here. And she said, that's a mess. She said, I'm going to start loading up these bookcases with the books. And she took them out of the boxes and she started putting them in. But what she didn't know was that I was actually really looking forward to doing that. And I really wanted to be really specific and precise with it. But she was just doing a really good job cleaning up the house while I was out. And you know what? I'm going to have to confess something. When I came in and she was working really hard, cleaning up all this area, cleaning up all the boxes and putting the books in, I came in and I wasn't very happy with her. I said, this is what I wanted to do. And none of these books are in the right order. I'm going to have to start all over again. Now, maybe my tone was a little bit more negative than that. You know, I wasn't really sensitive to what she was doing. I wasn't showing tact. That's a funny word. When I think of tact, I think of blue tact. I don't know. But anyway, I didn't treat her very nicely. I wasn't very sensitive around her when she was actually doing a really good job cleaning up the house while I was actually out. So I think I could have treated Mrs. Baird a little bit better. You know, I was able to apologize to her and we started working together. Now, we're actually going in a specific genre here. I won't describe the genres to you just yet. But I just needed to acknowledge that I wasn't very sensitive to her. You know, I wasn't in her headspace. I didn't take time to consider what she was thinking and what she was doing. I just came barging in and said, that's not right. You know, I was a little bit opinionated and I wasn't very gracious. So today we're going to be talking a little bit more about tact, what it is and how we can treat others kindly. Because at the end of the day, all of these devotions, we're learning about Jesus. Now, Jesus was God and he loves you and he loves me and he came to change our lives and to sacrifice himself for us. So I think we should listen to Jesus because Jesus was very kind to others and he treated people the way they deserve to be treated. So I wonder, how do you go with tactness? Now that's another funny word. It kind of sounds like cactus. I'm not asking you how you go with cactus. I'm asking how you go with tactness. So how is it that you respond to people when you have a disagreement? You know, like we've been learning in Peacewise this year, conflict is inevitable. We can't escape conflict. We can either run away from it and put our head in the sand like a cactus, or we can go on the attack. Not a good option. We need to always aim, like Jesus, to make peace. We are to be peacemakers. So how do you respond to people when they're being mean? How do you respond to people when they're just wrong? You know, maybe they've just got the wrong answer. They put their hand up in class really quickly, or at home. I guess we're not really even in class, aren't we? They put their hand up on Zoom, put their hand up on Teams. I'm between two devices here, but they put their hand up on Teams and they just blurt out the answer and it's always wrong. How can you react to that sort of person? How can we speak the truth, that which is true, in a kind and loving way? So here's some tips, okay? I'm going to put them up on the screen here for showing tactness or being tactful. That's another interesting word. I'm learning a lot today. I hope you are too. You know, I think, first of all, now this is a little bit hard online, okay? This is hard when we're doing it digitally, but maybe think about when we're back at school and when you've been at school. Maybe you can watch someone's body language. Are they confident? You know, are they being silly? Maybe that someone says an answer in class, but they're just being a little bit funny or a little bit silly. Maybe you don't need to react in a negative way. Maybe you can just join them in laughter. You know, can you be watching their body language? You know, I think another thing to do is, you know, to create the right environment and think before you speak. You know, yesterday when I came in barging in, I didn't really think before I spoke. I didn't think about my wife's feeling and the way she was serving me and my household by unpacking all these books. I wonder, can you think before you speak? That's a really good tip to learn in life, boys and girls. But also, number three, determine the appropriate time. Sometimes you just need to hold back a little bit before you respond to someone. Maybe someone said something that maybe offended you. Maybe someone's been a little bit mean. Maybe someone's just wrong. They're not offending you, but they're just wrong. Maybe determine what the appropriate time is, girls and boys. Is it the best thing to snap back at them and go, "That's wrong. That's wrong." You know, take some time. You know, let them work through it themselves before you come on the attack there. And I think it's number four. It's really important, girls and boys, that we always choose our words carefully. You know, this is a very tactful thing to do. I wonder, you know, when you're taking your time, when you're holding back responding, can you choose your words carefully? What's a polite way to speak to someone? What's a really educated and articulate way to respond to people? Finally, number five, and this is where I mucked up the other day, but number five is this: never react emotionally. You know what? I might actually say never react over emotionally. Showing our emotions are a good thing. Like I've spoke about many times this year, emotions are given to us by God to understand and perceive the world around us. But I wonder, we probably should never react over emotionally. You know, if someone puts their hand up in class and says the wrong answer, you can't get worked up and cry and get angry. No. Control your emotions. Take a few deep breaths. Say a prayer. Take some time, remember, to think it through. Think about your answer and never react over emotionally. You know what? These are five ways that I think we can work on being tactful, or tactness, like the cactus, but not like the cactus. So I hope this was helpful, boys and girls. You know what? Term three is almost over. We're almost there. What a term it has been for us all. You know what? I hope you're all doing well. I've been praying for you each and every day, and I really hope you have a good term three break holiday. You know, I hope your football team has made it to the grand final. I hope you can have a really great rest. And you know what? I'm really looking forward to hopefully being back on campus in term four. The sun will be out. It'll be warm. It's going to be great. See you around. Bye.